165 teams in Class 2A, and we are down to our final two. Live from Radbert Arena in Normal, Illinois, it's the Class 2A Championship between the Chicago Christian Knights and the Breese Central Cougars. And a very pleasant good afternoon, along with former Michigan standout Megan Bauer, Adam Amin on hand, and Megan, a Chicago Christian team that's back to the championship match for the second consecutive year. A lot of offensive firepower, a lot of different offensive options. They're led by their senior setter, Madison Camp.
Well, I think one thing about Madison Camp is she has experience, and she's a great player. She's gone through the USA circuit, so she's been in big matches. She's played against great competition, and I really think she's the quarterback of this team and really controls the offensive front for Chicago Christian team. And tonight, they're really going to look for her to make those plays, to set up, to calm the court. And one of the great things about Madison Camp is she's so offensive. She has over 100 kills this season, which makes her special. She's a big setter. So the other team really has to make sure that they don't counter her just as a setter. They counter as an attacker, and they put up a big block in front of her.
Double-double yesterday in the semifinals in a three-game victory. On the other side, Breese Central has been here before as well. Jim Cook has brought this team downstate for the seventh time. They've been in the finals five separate times, and Breese Central has another offensive explosive player on their side of the net, and it's Jenna Heyman.
Well, and the one word that comes to mind when we talk about Jenna Heyman is athletic, and she's an incredible athlete. She's going to make some great plays tonight, and they really need her to be consistent. They're going to look for her experience and leadership tonight to carry them to a state championship, and I think that the one thing is that she's going to have to terminate efficiently. They're going to give her the ball a lot. She's going to take a lot of swings, and she just got to stay calm and just look within her experience and leadership and just be an athlete tonight and be the leader on this court.
A 345 clip, pretty efficient over the course of the semifinals yesterday for Jenna Heyman. Also 13 kills to lead this team. She led the team in digs and blocks and kills, so obviously Heyman is a force on that side of the net. Jim Cook has been here before. James Garcia, I think, got a big boost last year. He's a club coach, brings a club technique to this team, and I think he's ready to go for this season as well, and he is the favorite, his team, here at State in 2A.
Well, putting favorites aside, I think it's going to be an unbelievable match. Both teams been here before, have experience, so it's just going to be a great match with good volleyball.
Well, we get set for our public address and the starting lineups coming up next. It's Carol Cazola on our public address here at Illinois State University.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the IHSA Class 2A Championship match between Breese Central and Chicago Christian. For the home team, the Cougars of Breese Central, who enter the match with a record of 30 wins and 11 losses, please meet coach Jim Cook, who has a record of 114 wins and 68 losses in a five-year career. For the visiting team, the Knights of Chicago Christian, who enter the match with a record of 29 wins and 11 losses, please meet coach James Garcia, who has a record of 88 wins and 28 losses in a three-year career. And now, let's meet the starters. For Breese Central, a 5'5" senior, number 3, Lauren Marcus. For Chicago Christian, a 5'11" sophomore, number 5, Emily Lindemolder. For Central, a 5'7" senior, number 11, Shelby Corman. For Chicago Christian, a 6'1" senior, number 4, Madison Camp. For Central, a 5'8" junior, number 9, Meredith Timmons. For Chicago Christian, a 6'1" junior, number 3, Maggie Camp. For Central, a 5'9" senior, number 12, and captain, Jenna Heyman. For Chicago Christian, a 6'1" junior, number 12, Becky DeRider. For Central, a 6-foot junior, number 14, Taylor Voss. And for Chicago Christian, a 5'7" freshman, number 2, Emily Workman. For Central, a 5'4 junior, number 15, Taylor Wilkin. And for Chicago Christian, a 6-foot senior, number 6, Stacy Camp. Okay, and the libero for Chicago Christian, a 5'6 junior, number 19, Selene Hahn. The floor officials for this match are Patty Bloomhorst from Mendota and Linda Wilson from Jacksonville, who will serve as umpires. Line judges for the match are Connie Scott from Polo and Gina Fay from Chester. Barb Maui and Mark McKinnon serve the IHSA as the official coordinators. Let's play some volleyball.
And we bring it to you from Redbird Arena. Doug Collins scored on the campus of Illinois State University, the Class 2A Championship. Breese Central searching for state championship number 4. Chicago Christian downstate for the third time, all coming in the last 4 years. The defending runners up, and the Knights at 29-11 look for their first state title. We talked about Madison Camp, Megan, and this is a player that, you know, as we've talked about, the U.S. national circuit, missed a couple of matches actually during the season to go play with a silver medalist team in the Youth Olympics. Jenna Heyman on the other side of the floor had a big match yesterday. Those seem to be the cogs in both of these offenses and really at the net.
Right, and both of them, this is a big match for both of them. I think they really are the leaders of their team, and they really do a good job of controlling the court, whether, you know, on both sides of the net. And I think tonight they're really going to have to get off to a good start early. It's key for both of these teams to get off to a good start early, settle into their rhythm, and play their style of volleyball.
Heyman had the best efficiency last night, 345 with 13 kills, 5 blocks, 8 digs. Big match for Heyman. And her Cougars start off with service. Madison Camp, her first touch goes to Emily Lindemulder, and the sophomore sends it long, and we're underway in the Class 2A Championship.
Well, it looked like they had that play set up early and just didn't execute well, but it was a great play. Didn't have much of a block in front of her. That's one play they have to execute for the rest of this match.
And Heyman is the middle blocker on the side for Breese Central. Camp to the outside for Maggie Camp. You'll hear that last name a lot today. You'll see that a lot as well. Jenna Heyman with her first termination of the match, and it's a 2-0 start.
Well, as we said earlier, Jenna Heyman is such an athlete. She accelerates so high, and I think she moves from pin to pin so well. She's a great blocker, able to get off the net and elevate very high for that kill.
Breese Central on top, and it comes from the service of the senior Lauren Marcus. Madison Camp pushing outside and a block. Shelby Corman teaming up with Heyman again, and it's a 3-0 Cougar advantage. You see the athleticism of Jenna Heyman in the early goings in game number 1. Camp, and again to the outside for another attack for Maggie Camp. The 6'1 junior puts it away.
Well, a very smart swing there by Maggie Camp. Set was a little bit outside. She brought it in, aimed for that deep corner. It's an incredibly hard shot to defend.
Maggie and Stacy Camp are sisters. Emily Camp is their first cousin. Madison Camp is their second cousin. Heyman getting high. It's a 4-hit violation off the top of the tape with Madison Camp and Becky DeRuyter on that backside block. Very imposing figures, both 6'1".
Well, on that last play, Jenna Heyman did a nice job of elevating, but she kept the ball a little bit too out in front of her, wasn't able to get that ball over the net.
A 4-2 advantage for the Cougars off the service air. Shelby Corman, one of the setters, goes to the back row. Maggie Camp on the pass, and passing game not great early, but Camp makes up for the rough reception with a kill.
Well, an extremely aggressive swing by Maggie Camp. She's done a nice job of attacking the cross-court shot. She's got to keep going there, especially when she sees that seam in the block.
Emily Camp into the front row. Madison Camp on service. Taylor Wilkin, a solid pass. Heyman in the middle. What a one-on-one opportunity with DeRuyter there.
Well, you can't leave Jenna Heyman one-on-one against any blocker because she's going to put that ball on the ground. You got to make sure you know where she is at all times on the court.
The track superstar gets high into the air. This is Meredith Timmons on service. Madison Kemp setting up to Derrida. Saw a lot of that during the state tournament run a season ago. Becky Derrida, team leader in kills and blocks.
Well, she just put it right back at him and really counterattacked from Jenna Heyman. And I think that Derrida's going to be a key to this match as well. They have to make sure they get it to their middle blockers a lot instead of just using the pin hitters.
Madison Kemp out of the play. A back row attempt from Maggie Kemp.
A nice aggressive way to put the ball over the net. A lot of teams would just give them a free ball. Have to stay aggressive because both teams have such a dynamic offense.
The Riders up there with Emily and Stacy Kim. Breakdown of the passing for Breeze Central, sending it over. Han, Madison Kemp to Emily. And Chicago Christian has its first lead of the 2A championship.
Great attack down the line from Chicago Christian. They have to keep staying aggressive throughout this match.
Maggie Kemp on service as the Knights have run off three in a row. Readjustment and second system opportunity, although Emily Kemp will have to set Stacy. Seemed like everybody cheated up for Emily Kemp, and she had, or rather, Stacy Kemp, she had plenty of room to work with.
Well, she did a nice job of aiming for those deep corners. I really like how Chicago Christian's hitters are attacking the perimeter of the volleyball court. It's common to see hitters try to hit straight down, but with a big block in front of you, that's not the best way to get kills.
Heyman able to side it out in a much-needed one of that, ending a four-point spurt for Chicago Christian.
Well, I think they're going to look to Jenna Heyman for a lot of their side outs, especially when they need it in these pressure points throughout the match.
We saw Timmerman and Maui up front along with Taylor Voss. Timmerman is a freshman in the middle right now. Stacy Kemp off hands. Heyman is there for a dig. Great save from Shelby Corman. Madison Kemp, another dig taken out of the play and a free ball. Need to pick up a kill here in second system. They will with Taylor Voss.
Great aggressive swing. She has an incredibly fast arm swing right through the block. And into right back. Right back defender has to be ready for that ball to come cross court.
Madison Kemp pushing outside for Stacy. Inbounds on a block up front from Timmerman and Voss.
Well, right now, Breeze Central has done such a good job of putting up a big block in front of the Chicago Christian attackers.
Out blocking them 2-0 in the early, going in the first 15 points of the 2A championship. Emily Kemp with a tap over. Paige Maui able to tool the block. Maui, the junior, solid match in the early going yesterday, kind of broke down towards the end, but ended up with four kills on 17 swings. And how about this, a 4-0 run for Chicago Christian, answered back by Breeze Central. Back row, Maggie Kemp into the tape, and it's a 10-7 Breeze Central lead with five in a row.
Well, right now, Chicago Christian's beating themselves. They have a lot of errors. They need to keep staying aggressive, but limit their errors going into the second half of this set.
And Heyman's service is really keeping Chicago Christian out of system right now.
Well, I think that's a game plan for both teams, especially with both teams with huge hitters. They have to serve aggressive, try to get the offenses out of system.
Madison Kemp back outside looking for Stacy down the line. That tides out a half dozen points for Chicago Christian.
Stacy Kemp taking a big swing down the line. That's an aggressive shot, hard to defend, hard to execute on. She did a nice job of putting that ball inbounds and aggressive.
Lindsay Heisinga comes on for service, had a good job yesterday of service during the semifinals and comes up with a dig. Madison Kemp, left-handed shot over, dug by Corman. Voss has to set it, one-on-one, and Linda Mulder was there. Linda Mulder able to pick up the termination.
Well, Breeze Central has done a nice job of just playing good defense and making it hard for Chicago Christian to come up with kills, and that's frustrating. Chicago Christian on the other side doing a nice job of saying, we're not going to get a lot of kills on the first try, so we're going to have to come back with two or three swings.
Timmerman blocked back. Maui, same result. Voss keeping it alive, and it's dug by Maggie Kemp. This is Stacy Kemp. Voss looking for Timmerman. Linda Mulder there, forces a lift. Three in a row for Chicago Christian to get back within a point. And the Knights hitting just 176 in the early going. Breese Central over 300 as a team. A service error. We talk about aggressive serving. That's something that James Garcia really focused on. Said, I'll be happy if we lose aggressively. And yesterday they served aggressively, six service aces.
Well, when you get to this point in the season, there's no looking back. You should just play aggressive, enjoy the moment. No, go with what you got you here, and I guarantee you they were aggressive the entire road to the state championship match, so he knows that that works for his team.
They had to be a very difficult conference schedule for Chicago Christian coming out of the Suburban Christian Conference, and a difficult state run as well. Emily Camp off the net, sending it long, and the Cougars have scored the last three.
Well, it's just been a matter of a lot of hitting errors, and right now they just have to keep staying aggressive, keep going with it. It's early in this match.
Three-point pass, shoot set for Lindemalder, able to put it down. And that's one of the first times you've seen a well-executed offensive set for Chicago Christian.
Well, I think Breese Central is doing a nice job of serving aggressive and limiting the amount of opportunity Chicago Christian has had to set up their entire offense. And that was a three-point pass, had all three options in the front row, letting Madison Camp kind of run her full offense.
Timmerman, an aggressive swing to the corner for a side out. The freshman coming up with a big swing here, and Timmerman, a 12-kill match in the super sectional. The freshman came up with a big match to guide this team to the state tournament. That's got to be pretty impressive for as young of a player as Timmerman is to step into this type of role as a middle blocker.
Right, and I think as a freshman, it's almost an advantage in a way because you don't really understand how big of a match this is, and you're just kind of playing. You're having a good time. You're just in the moment, and you don't really have a lot to go off of or add pressure to yourself. So
Madison Camp able to run it down, a free ball to the corner. A little indecision on Wilkins' part. Linda Mulder pushes it near side, and Wilkin there again. Came in on two. Nearly a lift on Hahn. Timmerman's blocked one-on-one by Linda Mulder. Second block of the match for the Knights, and it comes off the sophomore's arms.
Well, Maddie Timmerman just taking a big swing there. She's got to make sure she picks an angle to go at instead of right into the blocker.
Double block up there. Linda Mulder and Camp trying to deny Meredith Timmons. Lift called on Selene Hahn, and the Cougars able to side out. We've traded points over the last five scores. Lauren Marcus back in as Maddie Timmerman steps off the floor. That means Heyman is back into the front row. She's got to deal with Madison Camp. Two studs we talked about in our open, both at the net right now. Pancaked up on that second touch, but it hits the floor. And the Cougars have a five-point advantage, showing no hesitancy. On the other side, Chicago Christian, and Madison Camp admitted it yesterday. She said, I think we played a little bit scared, and that's something that you cannot afford when you get to this stage of the season.
Right, and you can't afford that, especially when you're playing a good Breese Central team. You can't be hesitant. And right now, I think Chicago Christian is just thinking a little too much about where they are and what kind of a match this is, instead of just really just getting into this moment and playing their volleyball.
Well, maybe that helps. Madison Camp with a free ball to the corner just ends up finding the sideline for a side out. And that's going to kill a little bit of that momentum. It's ironic because James Garcia, the coach of Chicago Christian, club coach, club mentality, club technique to this team when he brought his knowledge to the program a couple of years ago. He's about as calm of a coach as you'll see, and you'd like to see his team kind of develop that and adapt that type of attitude at this stage of the season.
Right, and I think he does a nice job of staying calm because, you know, as you get into these big matches, you know, your emotions can get to you and you put a lot of pressure on yourself. So as a coach, you want to make sure you stay steady and just have that consistent personality so that your team can look to you for stability and some advice and be able to trust that.
And a big time play from an upperclassman and Becky DeRuyter coming up with a solo block for a side out. Answering immediately back comes Taylor Voss, the junior, with a kill. So a couple of runs from both teams early in this opening game, but been trading points back and forth. A 5-point Breese Central lead. Camp to DeRuyter. And DeRuyter, as you mentioned, is going to have to be big over the course of this match. She really kind of paved the way last year. Six blocks 5 kills in the championship match a season ago. DeRuyter has really taken a big step into that M1 role.
Well, I think she's an incredible athlete as well. She's going to make some big plays. And the cool thing about Chicago Christian is they have an unbelievable balanced offense. They have some studs on their team, but they really dish it out to a lot of different players. And I think DeRuyter is one of those players that they need a little bit more offense out of tonight in order to come up successful in tonight's match.
Madison Camp trying to quarterback her team. The Knights are back within 3 after that block from DeRuyter and Stacey Camp. Hyman with a readjustment, and she forces a net violation on, looks like, Becky DeRuyter.
Well, Breese Central has done a nice job in siding out. They got this 4-point or 5-point cushion, and they've done a nice job of just keeping it steady and playing steady volleyball.
And let's see if DeRuyter is really coming up big during this rotation. And now steps off the floor for Huizinga, and Emily Lindeball, they're back on now. Let's see if Chicago Christian can put something together. Really 3, 4, 5 points, as Megan mentioned. That's been the cushion right now for Breese Central. Free ball opportunity, and Linda Mulder able to flex it through the block.
Well, this is a good opportunity for Chicago Christian to go on a bit of a run here. They can't afford to keep trading points back and forth, down 2 points going into the end of set one.
Huizinga came in there for the pass. Boss has the set, and a freshman with a kill, Maddie Timmerman. Big side out after Chicago Christian had scored 4 of 5 points. You see DeRuyter check in. She'll then step off the floor so the libero, Selene Hahn, can come back in. This is Jessica Hale setting out of the back row with service. Camp with an athletic set, able to keep that alive, but Linda Mulder into the tape.
Well, that was an incredibly athletic set. I just don't think her middle blocker thought she was going to get it. Wasn't ready there. They have to be ready driving on every single set.
James Garcia is going to use the first time out of the Class 2A championship. It's a 22-18 lead, and the defending runners-up are on the ropes in game number one. James Garcia in his third season at the helm of the Chicago Christian program, 88-28. It's a team that went to the state championship in 2007 under Leah Bruskowitz in her final campaign. 92 victories for Bruskowitz over the course of a 4-season career with Chicago Christian. And kind of expound a little bit on what a club mentality from James Garcia brings to the table. He talked a lot about technique last year when this team made it down to state.
Well, I think in club, it's a longer season, and you have more time to focus on technique, and you really try to break down each player. You have a lot more specialization. You get more, you know, you have more options in regards to who's playing for you. And I think that's a good mentality to bring to high school players who you kind of have to select from the pool that you're given and really develop that as a team.
And several of James Garcia's Knights have played club volleyball for him. Right now, his Knights are down 4 in game number 1, and that'll help. Service error coming from Jessica Hale, and a side on for the Knights.
Well, when you come out of a timeout, especially towards the end of a set, the last thing you want to do is miss a serve. You kind of hand over the momentum out of the timeout to the other team.
Emily Workman, a freshman with over 50 aces this season, to the back line. Timmons on the pass, Timmerman on the attack and the kill.
Nice swing there by Timmerman. She struggled early, hitting it into the block. She did a nice job of mixing up her angles on that shot.
Both teams hitting over 200 here in game number 1. Chicago Christian's block has come up big over the last 10-15 points or so, but the Cougars are 2 points away. Madison Camp. It's a lift violation against Madison Camp, and it makes it game point for the Cougars.
Well, that's a pretty frustrating call. I don't think it was the right one, but Madison Camp has to come back and settle her team down.
Needing to play perfect volleyball, or the Cougars will take the opening frame. Side out kill. Patty Blumhorst is our up official, making the call against Madison Camp. Still 4 game points to try to erase. Came in a rough reception. Timmons on the outside. Good save from Workman. Maggie Camp. Keeping the Knights in and back within 3. They'll race 2 game points. They'll have 3 more to go. Timmerman into a double block. Corman, Madison Camp there. On a bump set, so Camp can jump for it. Heyman with a dig, sent over on 2. Linda Mulder. Tool of a block on the outside, and Meredith Timmons puts away game 1 for the Breese Central Cougars, knocking off the defending runners-up in game number 1 of the Class 2A championship.
Well, Breese Central did a really nice job of just playing a steady game. They side out well. They didn't do anything too fancy, and they just took care of their game, didn't make a lot of errors, and I think that was key in their first set victory.
Looking for state championship number 4, the Cougars take the opening frame, 25-21. We're back with game 2 next on the IHSA television network. 25-21, Breese Central in the opening frame. The defending runners-up, Chicago Christian Knights, down a set. Adam Amin, Megan Bauer back courtside at Redbird Arena. And Breese Central, a lot of teams are going to focus in on Jenna Heyman. And obviously she had the brunt of the offense, 5 kills out of the 13. But this is a team in Breese Central that does not make a lot of mistakes. They held true to that in set number 1.
Yeah, and I think that's a huge reason why they came away with the win in set 1 is they... Jenna Heyman did a nice job of carrying their offense, but the rest of the offense came along with her and didn't make a lot of errors, got some kills, and helped her out.
Rest of the offense, just 3 attack errors in game number 1. A 216 clip, bettering Chicago Christian's 205. And the Knights have service with Workman getting things going in game number 2. And Jenna Heyman, no touch up front, and the Knights open up with a side out. It is really impressive to see Heyman, even in the fact that she sent that a little bit long. She gets so high above the block. Not a very tall team in Breese Central, but there things happen.
Right, and because she elevates so high, she can almost pick where she wants it to go.
2-0 start for the Knights. And the service of Emily Workman. She'll attack Wilkin for a service ace. That's one of the more aggressive services we've seen from the Knights. I want to give credit to a freshman for not being afraid to do that. Team that averages about 3 aces per game, had 6 of them yesterday. There's a service error, and the Cougars on the board, and Corman to the back line. We see Jenna Heyman up front with Taylor Voss.
Well, Chicago Christian has got to keep serving aggressive throughout the rest of this match to keep Jenna Heyman a little bit less involved in the Breese Central offense.
They're going to go to Heyman here. Didn't look like there was that much of a touch, but play continues. It'll be a night point anyway. A side out and a 4-1 start for Chicago Christian.
A few hitting errors that we didn't see a lot of in the first set coming from Breese Central right now.
Corman pushing outside for Voss. That's a break for the Knights. Their block was a little bit late because they're so focused on Jenna Heyman. That's something that Breese Central takes advantage of a lot because teams are so focused on Heyman in the middle.
Right, and they double block her all of the time. You have to. If you give Jenna Heyman 1 blocker, she's going to terminate. But they really have to make sure that they spread their offense.
That time Heyman saw the double block and actually put it through the seam, but sent it a little bit long. And Jim Cook will use a timeout for the Breese Central Cougars. Just like Breese Central did in game number 1, Chicago Christian takes a lead in game number 2 to start. It's 6-1.
Well, right now, Breese Central, I don't know if they're a little bit too excited or what, but they've given Chicago Christian most of their points just on hitting errors, and so they have to calm down and make sure they snap their wrists, bring their arms through aggressively, and swing for kills.
5 errors, as we mentioned, in game number 1. Already 5 attack errors on 7 attempts for the Breese Central Cougars here in game number 2.
Right, so they have to hit a lot more efficiently. They've passed pretty well in the beginning of the second set. I don't think their ball control is what's leading to this. It's just swinging for kills. Try not to focus on the Chicago Christian block and just go for the kill, go for the ground.
Stacy Camp on service. Heyman takes the pass, now the leap into the double block. It's block number 5 for the Knights tonight.
Well, we talk about hitting straight down, Jenna Heyman can definitely do that, but right now she really needs to focus on swinging the perimeter to the court and hitting shots instead of right down in the Chicago Christian block.
Timmons backside, joust at the net, and that's pushed down by Emily Lindemolder with a little bit of help from Maggie Camp. That's a big, imposing front line right now. Maggie at 6'1", Madison at 6'1", and Lindemolder 5'11". And a great start for the Knights here in game two. That's into the tape from Taylor Voss. This is what we're used to a little bit more from the Chicago Christian Knights. Corman with a good free ball, and Hahn is there. Only one attack option, and Maggie Camp on the outside. Really cut that one in, but centered a little bit long, and the Cougars side out.
Tough shot there by Maggie Camp. The set was a little bit outside, kind of an awkward angle. Went a little bit too sharp on the cross-court shot.
Timmons on service. Hahn, Camp on two. That's very, very smooth from Madison Camp. You mentioned it, she is an attacker. She's in the front row right now and has a couple more rotations up there.
Well, at the end of the first set, she got called on the lips, and I like how she came back and was just as aggressive here in the second set.
Her third state title run. She's been a starter since freshman year. Service ace, Emily Lindemulder. What a start for Chicago Christian, 11 of the first 13. Bouncing back after dropping set number one. Lindemulder's got some lethal topspin, but Timmons able to sprawl out and save it. How about Lindemulder, a middle blocker, picking up a dig. Camp on two, got it down.
Well, right now, Breese Central is just looking for someone to put the ball on the ground, and they're having a hard time getting their offensive rhythm back.
Still without a kill here in game number two, Breese Central. Lindemulder led the team in aces with 75. It was after Timmons, who is true to the test. Camp on two again. What a save by Corman. A short arm free ball from Heyman, but she'll take it. It's a much needed side out after the Knights have dominated the early portions here in game number two.
Well, Jenna Heyman a little bit frustrated with that front row series. She wasn't able to come up with very many kills, and I think for her, it's really going to be key for her to stay calm, and next time she has the opportunity to get to the front row is to be a little bit more efficient.
This is where Chicago Christian's experience being here just last year may play a factor. Camp, a service here, giving it right back. This is something interesting that was kind of shocking, really, more than anything else. Chicago Christian played 11 three-game matches this year. They went 2-9, which is pretty surprising. They had to win a three-game match yesterday to get to the finals.
Well, I think it's definitely going to help them because they're going to have to force this game to go to three to win this championship, and I think that's going to, they're going to have to pull upon that experience in those 11 three-game matches.
Service ace, Jessica Hale. Two in a row put together until now. Kind of a herky-jerky middle portion of game number two with a lot of service errors.
Well, I think Breese Central, in order to crawl back into this second set, has to serve aggressive, but there's that fine line where they can't make too many errors.
Timmerman, that's a much-needed side-out kill.
She takes a big swing here. Nice cross-court draw. I really like how she has come through the first set, and now she's taking a lot of swings, picking those angles and being a little bit smarter as an attack.
And you said that was an issue in game number one, where she was going directly into the middle of the block. Another service error for Breese Central.
Well, it just looks like Breese Central is a little bit frustrated, having gotten off to a great start here in the second set. They need to calm down. It's still early in this set.
Isinga on service. Heyman with a solid pass. Timmons on the outside. Lindemulder teaming up with Emily Camp for the block.
A huge block Chicago Christian puts up. Breese Central's attackers really have to pick better and smarter shots.
This time off the head of Emily Camp. Great save by Hisinga, but no touch after that. And a side out for Breese Central. Timmerman will step off the floor, and back to the service line goes Lauren Marcus. Only 17 service aces for Marcus, and that was tops on this team. Less than one ace per game average for Breese Central during the regular season coming into state tournament action. Smooth looking loft to the corner from Emily Lindemulder.
Well, that's pretty frustrating play here for Breese Central. They got a free ball and gave it right back as an overpass. Not something you want to do, especially moving into the second half of this set.
10-point advantage. And a service error. Knight scored 13 of the first 16 points here in game number two. It's been a little more back and forth since. Corman. Not the best reception. Madison Camp keeps it in play, and it's sent over by Sammy Brunius, the sophomore defensive specialist in the match. And side out for the Knights, trying to force a game number three.
Well, I think right now they're really trying to force the ball to Jenna Heyman. They're trying to get her on fire. She carries a lot of emotion for this team, and right now they're Chicago Christian's done a phenomenal job of putting up a big blocker, limiting the shots that she's able to hit.
Timmons gets another go, blocked back, good coverage from Wilkin. Voss has to readjust. Madison Kemp to the outside for Nagy, and a tool of a block. Megan, you look at the total number of attacks for Breese Central, and just about any coach will gladly take 29 of 59 out of their middle attackers. That means at least your passing is doing well, but so far just an 0-17 clip for Breese Central.
Great, and I think that, you know, they're setting a lot of middle because Jenna Heyman is in the front row right now, but they're not as efficient as they would like to be, and I think that the tribute to Chicago Christian doing a nice job of just tracking their middle blockers. They know a lot of offense from Breese Central comes out of their middle hitters.
And Heyman is hitting a zero clip so far for the match. 6 kills, 6 errors. Overpass nearly put down by Maggie Camp, and Heyman has to send over a free ball. Hahn, Camp, Linda Mulder. A Cougar in the net. And it's a 13-point Chicago Christian lead in game number two. Stacy Camp. Heyman on the outside, able to tool the block of Madison Camp. Goal number 7 for Heyman to lead the Cougars. Linda Mulder has 7 to lead the Knights.
Well, a smart play there by Breese Central, moving Jenna Heyman to the outside, giving her a little bit better of a look, a different look at the court. She's able to come up with a big kill.
Outstanding service from Meredith Timmons. It was Timmons' service yesterday that really got things going for Breese Central in the semis. Under the knockoff, Bloomington Central Catholic. Another good service from Timmons, forcing the Knights' hand defensively, and a couple of points in a row served by Timmons on the back line.
Well, I think down by 10 points, if you're Breese Central, you're really just trying to find momentum. You're just trying to gain that momentum through the end of this set and just carry it on.
Stacy Camp on the pass, Linda Mulder on the attack. Sent it wide. Four in a row put together by the Cougars here. Down by Corman to track it to the sideline. Really going after Stacy Camp right now. He's having a rough go at it on the back line passing. James Garcia is going to use a timeout. Still an 8-point advantage for the Knights, but a little bit of a push from Breese Central in game two.
Well, yeah, they've got back to their old ways of serving aggressive and being confident. Everything they did in this second set has been with a little bit of a hesitation. And as we saw, you know, in the first set, that doesn't get you anywhere. And you just really have to play and play hard and play with what you know you're good at. And I think Breese Central fell back a little bit because they went away from their aggressive serving and aggressive offense.
It was a tough schedule for Breese Central that got them prepared to come to state. Same conference as the defending champion, Freeburg Lady Midgets. That's the Cahokia Conference. Freeburg defeated Chicago Christian in the finals last season. There's a team in Breese Central that lost 3 different times to Freeburg over the course of the season and then finally beat them in the Columbia Regional in the finals in a 3-game match that went wire to wire tight between the two teams. They're able to get to the Breese Central sectional, work their way to state, and by Jenna Heyman leading the team with 6 kills. Maddie Timmerman also the freshman with 6 kills, both out of the middle. That kills a lot of momentum after a 5-0 run. Another service error, which we've seen a lot of on both sides here in game number two. Chicago Christian is 3 points away from forcing a third game. Linda Mulder is exactly who you want at the back line for service. That's why. Top spin serve for an ace. And the Knights look like they're going to get to another 3-game match in the finals. Corman for Heyman. Somebody hit the tape, and it looks like it was Madison Camp. I'll make that DeRuyter up front, who ended up touching the tape. But back to a 9-point game, two. Heyman out of the front row. Timmerman is in. Maggie Camp a little tight. Madison Camp knows what to do with it. Such an advantage, all that reach for Madison Camp. And a lefty at that, much easier for a left-handed setter to make that play than a right-handed.
Right, it's just in her body momentum is going that way anyway. She does a nice job of seeing the blockers and finding that open spot in the court.
10 game points to work with. And game two to the Knights. All Chicago Christian in game number two, and it's gonna take three for the second straight year to determine a 2A champion. Game three coming up next on IHSA TV. Game one to Breese Central, game two to Chicago Christian in class 2A. Last season, Chicago Christian dropped a three-game match in the championship to the Freeburg Lady Midgets. This season, it'll take three to determine a champion against Breese Central. The Knights from Palos Heights, Illinois, suburban Chicago. Just 3-9 in three-game matches this season. 9 of their 11 losses came in three games. One of their three victories came yesterday in the semifinals. Megan, a lot of the time, game number three means more mental toughness than physical execution, although
right.
That's a big part.
You gotta have a gut check, and you just gotta be aggressive. You can't think about it.
Jenna Heyman gets things going in game three. Kill number 8 for Heyman. Lauren Marcus, the senior, back to the service line. Reception from Maggie Camp. Linda Mulder off the backside between the block of Timmons and Heyman.
I think Heyman elevates so high, and on her block here, she goes straight up. You want to make sure on your block you don't just go straight up, but you go over the net too.
Linda Mulder with the kill, now service. Jenna Heyman. 11 state medals in track and field. High jump, long jump, triple jump, 100 meter dash. An older sister that played for Breese Central on the 06 and 07 state teams. Big kill out of the middle for Becky DeRuyter, and we're tied at 2. DeRuyter having a solid match, still without an attack error, 4 of 6. Heyman able to tool the block. We've seen her move to the outside position and starting to get a little bit of rhythm going.
Well, so much a part of the emotion and the momentum for Breese Central comes from Jenna Heyman. If she's playing well, the team tends to go right behind her. So it's important in this third set that she gets off to a good start.
Emily Camp dug by a sprawling Marcus. Maui stuffed by DeRuyter, but coverage there from Voss and a free ball. Madison Camp in the middle for DeRuyter. Voss with Corman out of the play as to set. That's pushed over by Emily Camp, and a Cougar in the net. Tied at 1-2, and now 3 in game 3. We mentioned Chicago Christian's 3-game record. Breese Central, on the other hand, including yesterday's win in the semis over Bloomington Central Catholic, 8-2 in 3-game matches this season. Service error, and Breese Central out in front. Maddie Timmerman is into the front row now. Half a dozen kills, right behind Heyman's 9 as Jenna serves. Stacy Camp, Heyman with a dig. Joust at the net, and DeRuyter able to beat Timmerman.
Well, it's important for Breese Central when Jenna Heyman is in the back row that they can still get good offense. They have to make sure that they balance out their offense when she is in the back row.
Timmerman's done a nice job of playing in the front row, the freshman, once he's been in there. Service ace for the Knights, delivered by Lindsay Heisinga, really a serve specialist. Able to put Chicago Christian in front for the first time in game 3. Heyman sending it deep, and a good read by Sammy Brunius.
A few unforced errors here for Breese Central, ones that you can't afford going into a third set.
Three in a row for the Knights. Voss sets to move it off the block. Emily Kemp will send it to the outside for Stacy. Maui off the top of the tape and Kemp able to play it up. Stacy Kemp again. Voss's fingertips on that one. She'll have the attack on the backside. Four hit called off the top of the tape.
Well, Breese Central's really having a hard time of getting the ball past the Chicago Christian block. Chicago Christian's done a phenomenal job of having two blockers up at all times.
Out blocking Breese Central 7-2 are the Knights. Timmerman having to readjust on that set, but still able to find the floor and a side out. Much needed for Breese Central back within two. Jenna Heyman calling out signals to Timmerman, the freshman. That's a senior telling a freshman what's up. Fellow senior Jessica Hale to the back line. Ill-timed error and a three-point advantage for the Knights. Workman, the freshman, into the match, and Emily Kemp steps on. You saw some aggressive service from Workman in game number two. There's another one, and it forces an overpass. Slide play, Linda Mulder. Blocked back. Feels like the first time since game number one we've seen the block be aggressive for Breese Central.
Well, a nice job moving laterally, getting in front of that slide attempt from Chicago Christian. Breese Central did a nice job of tracking their hitters on that last play.
Maui and Timmerman teaming up for the block and a side out to bring the Cougars back within a pair. Shalane Hahn, high pass. The outside, Stacy Kemp is dug. Timmons.
Well, Breese Central in that first set, what got them there was just being aggressive. That was such a great swing right to the deep corner. They have to continue to define the line between being aggressive and making too many errors.
Breese Central three of the last four, and Chicago Christian calls a timeout as the Cougars have brought themselves back within one in game three. Jim Cook, 16th season. At the helm of Breese Central, 23rd coaching season. He's 10 wins shy of 600 for his career. Spent time at Trenton Westland before coming to Breese Central. James Garcia, on the other hand, just in season number three. He's had a slew of his players play for him in club ball. Madison Camp, one of them. Emily Lindemulder as well. Selene Hahn is libero, kind of a pet project. Actually, Hahn ended up turning into a libero after being an outside hitter. And Hahn was converted to a libero by Garcia. Brought her up to varsity as a freshman just to get her some experience. And Garcia has seen his team play good defense over the last set and a half. The Cougars, though, 3 of 4 scored and back within one. And we're tied on a service ace from Taylor Wilkin. Fifth tie of game three.
Nice way to come out of a timeout with an aggressive serve.
Kemp, and back to Kemp. Sent over. Hale pushing outside for Timmons. Timmons hitting negative figures, but she's had two kills in her last two swings, coming at clutch moments.
Well, I think that shows incredible gut. She's taken big swings and just really swung for kills instead of to keep it in bounds, and that's done fared well for her so far.
Four in a row. Sided out on that attack from Stacy Kemp. Tied again.
It's a nice swing. Out of system, went cross court, attacked the block, came up big with the kill.
Yeah, that size advantage on Corman. 6-1 against 5-7. Linda Mulder, a change of pace. Good save from Wilkin. Simmons, a free ball. Maggie Kemp. Linda Mulder. Little readjustment by Linda Mulder to put Chicago Christian in front.
Well, Breese Central really has to limit the amount of free balls that they're sending over. Instead, send a down ball. Be a little bit more aggressive. Make Chicago Christian work for their points.
Timmerman against the double block. Picks a side and comes away with a kill.
It's a big swing there. by Timmerman, taking great shots, hitting around the block while had two big blockers in front of her and did a nice job of going through the block.
Going up against Madison Camp and Emily Lindemalder, and now back to the service line, Lauren Marcus. Race to 15 in game number three. Very tough angle, kept in by Maggie Camp. Hale to Heyman. Big time swing from Jenna Heyman to bring Breese Central up a point.
Well, now that she's in the front row, they're gonna need a lot of productivity from her before she heads into the back row again. Try to pull away a little bit.
She's got three, four rotations up there, and another service ace for Breese Central, put down by Lauren Marcus. Beach-style float taken by Maggie Camp. Tight pass, and the joust won by Madison Camp. Going up against Jenna Heyman. That's a really fun matchup to watch between those two.
Well, Madison Camp did a nice job of just tipping it right below her. Jenna Heyman gets up so far that you're not going to go through. You're not going to go above her, but you have to go around her. She did a nice job of that.
Lindemalder on service. Handcuffed was Wilkins, so Timmons trying to be aggressive with the down ball, but sends it long. Side out for Chicago Christian, and then following it up with a point on the error to tie us up at a dozen apiece. Sent long by Lindemalder, and Breese Central with a 13-12 lead. Halfway through set number three.
Both teams doing a good job of having a good side-out game. Not a lot of rallies, not a lot of runs in this third set.
The Ryder blocked by Heyman. Madison Camp was there. Voss nearly put it down, but a good save from Workman. Hectic possession on both sides, and Breese Central reloads with Heyman. Tap back by DeRuyter, one-on-one, and this time Heyman able to push it forward. Maggie Cam, longest rally of game three, and it ties us up at 13.
Big swing there by Maggie Cam. She's taken great swings all night. I really like her shot selection, moving her around the court. Very hard to block her.
Madison Camp into the back row. He's got DeRuyter, Emily, and Maggie Camp up front. Taylor Voss. Maggie Camp on the outside. A save, but a better read by Selene Hahn. Marcus dug it, but Hahn standing right on the sideline.
Maggie Camp taking another big swing instead, this time going line.
She's done a nice job of mixing it up, cross-court and line shots. Rough reception, but somehow Corman is able to put it away. Maggie Camp's arguing that Corman was in the net. Ten ties in game three. Full approach for Emily Camp, and able to put it away. Becky DeRuyter in the middle, five kills without an error on nine attacks, 5.56 clip. Breese Central still hitting under 100 for the match. Heyman trying to improve on that figure, and does. Ties us up at 15 with her 11th kill of the match.
Another athletic shot coming from behind the setter. They set her in front of the setter, coming around. It's hard to track her as a blocker. She elevates so well. She did a nice job putting that in the corner of the court.
24 kills for the tournament for Heyman, and now the Cougars are out in front. Back and forth we've gone in game number three to decide a 2A champion. Stacy Camp, Heyman there off the block for the day. Timmerman, one-on-one against DeRuyter, nearly put it down. Tried again, and it's a lift against Voss.
Nice transition play. Got a good dig, wasn't able to execute here on the attack. Chicago Christian again doing a nice job putting up a big block.
Isinga on service, Timmons saves it. Maui a free ball to the corner. Lindemalder. Kill number 10 for Emily Lindemalder, the sophomore. Chicago Christian with a one-point lead. Maui off the net, readjusts, flat-footed, dug by Madison Kemp. Emily Kemp to the outside. Stacy's dug by Timmons. Maui closer to the net this time, but blocked back. Linda Mulder and Kemp team up for the rejection, and the Knights with a two-point advantage.
Again, a big block, double block. They do such a good job of closing that seam, not allowing Breese Central to go through the block.
And a timeout from Jim Cook and the Breese Central Cougars. First timeout used by either side in game number three. Eight lead changes and a dozen ties here in game number three. Well, I guess what more would you expect, right?
Right, I mean, when you're in the state championship, you're playing hard, going hard for every point, so it's definitely expected to have such a good back and forth rally.
Breese Central's student section in one corner, on the opposite end of the floor, it's Chicago Christian student section, and both with solid contingents brought Breese Central from Southwestern Illinois, and making the drive to Normal. Chicago Christian out of Palos Heights in South Suburban Chicago. And the Knights, after being denied last year by Freeburg in three games, trying to come away with their first ever state championship. Up by two. And a big side out. And bring it back to a one-point game, three on the kill from Maddie Timmerman, the freshman who's had a great match so far today.
Right, she's taking some big swings. I think she started off a little bit slow, but she's really worked into her rhythm, found her shots late in this match.
Just four kills yesterday. She's more than double that total in the finals with nine and a 400-plus clip. Service from Jessica Hale. Out of system, Chicago Christian sends over a free ball. Maui on the outside. No one's going to get there. Maui with a big kill. That's a really impressive set from Corman going all the way across the net, just about antenna to antenna.
Right, and it really pushes the tempo and makes the blockers on Chicago Christian work, opening up a seam so that they can get that kill.
13 ties. It's a race to seven. High backside set, Emily Camp, and Heyman is there. The communication as Maui takes touch two, but Timmerman sends it long. Madison Camp into the front row with Emily Lindemulder and Stacy Camp. Watch out for Madison Camp, the left-handed setter. There's an attack option up front with Workman on service, but it's tied once again. First to six. Still have to win by 2-25. Stacy Camp forcing Madison back. Linda Mulder trying to find open floor space. Timmons, tip over the block.
Smart shot. Chicago Christian sucked back into their defense. She read that so well. Right here, right behind the block, no one was there.
Workman was playing deep. Cougars out by a point. Save from Heyman. Timmons tools the block.
Big swing there by Timmons. She's not a very big attacker, but she's done such a good job of working with what she has off the blocker's hands.
Timeout, Chicago Christian, and the Cougars 4 points away from a Class 2A title. Three in a row scored by Breese Central. The Knights trying to work themselves back. They expended so much energy in game two last season to make this monster comeback against Freeburg. They scored four of the final 5 points of game two, and they really seem like they ran out of gas in game number three. You hope that's not the case if you're James Garcia right now, a team that worked so hard to play so well up at the net. They've had a great block for the majority of the match so far, but the Knights are on the ropes right now, down two with 4 points to go for the Cougars.
Right, and they have to just continue to stay aggressive, get a good pass and a side out. Breese Central has to continue to be aggressive on the offensive front and limit their attack errors.
Camp tools the block. Much needed side out. Chicago Christian back within one. Stacy Camp, fourth kill of the match, and now back to serve. Heyman pushed it a little bit too far for Hale, and we're tied for the 15th time in game number three.
Well, Breese Central thought they had what they wanted, a nice pass.
Out of system once again, and Timmons with a roll shot dug by Stacey Camp. Madison to Maggie. Chicago Christian takes the lead.
Breese Central has to get a side out here. Get a nice pass, set up their hitters.
Heyman, tight to the net for Linda Mulder. Chicago Christian, 2 points away. Linda Mulder again. Jim Cook and the Cougars down to their final point of the 2010 season. It's a 24-21 Chicago Christian lead. Three championship points to work with. And the Knights trying to pick up their first ever state championship. Right now, Marco Quintana, one of the assistant coaches, is doing most of the talking. James Garcia, not a very vocal head coach. Right now, he's just on the outskirts of that huddle.
Well, I think they see the light at the end of this tunnel and a championship trophy right in front of them. They want to make sure that they keep their players calm and just get a nice pass. You don't have to do anything flashy. Get a dig right out of the chute and try to put it away right away.
3 championship points for Stacey Camp and the Knights. Timmons kept alive. Free ball sent over. The freshman, Timmerman, erases one championship point, stopping a 5-0 run.
As Jenna Heyman comes into the front row, just who they want, put up a good block, and able to terminate on transition. It's important that they play good defense in this rally.
Lauren Marcus, could this be her final point? The senior sends it over. Madison Camp, looking for Maggie. And for the first time in school history, the Chicago Christian Knights are state champions. Denied last year in 3 games. This season, James Garcia's Knights come out on top in 2A.
Well, they worked hard for it. They knew how it felt not winning in this situation last year. They came out with a vengeance and played really hard.
That's about as emotional as we've ever seen. James Garcia, so soft-spoken, such a high volleyball IQ, and bringing all that knowledge to a high school team. And there is his senior, Madison Camp, another trip to state for Madison Camp. And finally, the senior, hugging one of her many family members on this team, comes away with a state championship. The Chicago Christian Knights on top of 2A in 2010. The trophy presentation comes up next on IHSA Television.
Superintendent Kevin Meyer. Principal B. Kent Jones. Athletic Director Alan Warnicki. Trainer Marty Stewart. Head Coach Jim Cook. Assistant Coach Kelly Pothas. Assistant Coach Misty Becker. And now let's meet the players. Shelby Corman. Gina Hemmen. Emily Tysing. Taylor Voss. Taylor Wilkin. Paige Maui. Amanda Gebke. Jessica Hale. Allie Lackenburgess. Maddie Timmerman. Casey Schulte. Lauren Marcus. Meredith Timmons. And now will Coach Jim Cook and Breese Central step forward and receive your second place trophy. At this time, please meet the Knights of Chicago Christian, who finished the season in first place. Superintendent Bob Payne. Principal Eric Ellefson. AD Eric Brower. Trainer, Russ Lyons. Head coach, James Garcia. Assistant coach, Lauren Didion. Assistant coach, Marco Quintana. Assistant coach, Kate Delaney. Assistant coach, Deb Lindemolder. And now, let's meet the players. Annika Evenhaus. Emily Camp. Becky DeRider. Sammy Bronius. Selene Hahn. Emily Workman. Maggie Camp. Madison Camp. Emily Lindemolder. Stacy Camp. Jordan Von Borstel. Lindsay Huizinga. And now, will Coach James Garcia and Chicago Christian please step forward and receive your championship trophy.
Chicago Christian finishes the season 30-11 and wins the Class 2A state championship, and that's the first state title in school history. With us from Chicago Christian, we have from left to right Madison Camp, head coach James Garcia, and Stacy Camp. Coach, can you tell us what it feels like to be a state champion?
You know, I words can't describe this. I mean, in my short high school volleyball career, the many years that I've been coaching club, I've never felt anything like this. This is unbelievable. Just being able to come back here a second year and finally do it, I mean, this was, it's just unbelievable. It's indescribable right now.
Questions? Coach, considering how hard it is to move the first shot in.
They were, and I think realistically with the schedule that we have, that we had last year, the schedule that we have this year, the teams that we play, a lot of 3A and 4A schools that we play, we've taken them to 3. So playing 3 is nothing new to us. I would have liked to have won that first game, though. But, you know, the girls played their hearts out. They were loose. They were very energetic. And I don't think you could ask for a better third game, point for point. I think the biggest margin was 2 points at any one time. But for them to fight back when we were down, I think it was 21-19, right at the very end, they gave it their all, and that was good enough today.
Matt, you had to be encouraged, even though you lost that first game, you were playing a lot better than you did yesterday. And you had to feel like, okay, you know, we didn't win, but we're playing better, we're playing at a higher level.
Yeah, I think the thing that was encouraging for me as a coach to see was, one, the passes were very good. And I think that's key anytime you're playing the game. If you can get good passes throughout the game, you can consistently run your offense. And even though we lost that first game, we lost by 4 points, but the passing was good right off the bat. So I think, you know, going into that second game, we served a little bit more aggressive. We came out to a good lead right at the beginning, and we never let up. So with the good passing, we were able to run our offense. We were a little bit more calmer with that lead. So the third game, I think, was a little bit more hectic and playing point for point. You know, I think I looked at our host, Jerry, and I was ready to ask him for a defibrillator. Where you at, Jerry?
Coach, 8 blocks for points. You control your net pretty well. I guess you control Haven about as well as you can control her.
She's, you know, I was trying to find some information on her, and that girl is incredible. You know, we've played a lot of teams throughout the season with maybe one, two really good players. She was it in the middle. I mean, we have a very good middle, 2 very good middles of our own. And for them to go up against somebody like that, I think they did a good job, but she was outstanding. I mean, every seemed like every ball she hit, hit the floor at some point. So I think in that second game when we had the lead, we were a little bit more comfortable. We had the pressure on them. She was making some mistakes, and we were able to get some blocks on her at that point. But she is a very good player.
Madison, Stacy, can you guys describe how it feels after the disappointment of last year?
Great. I couldn't ask for anything more. I mean, to lose last year and to then come back and win this year is the greatest feeling ever.
Yeah, when you lose a game and then you know you have one more year. As a junior, you lose and you get second, and you're like, well, there's only one thing to do. You can get first next year. And we came and we worked hard the whole season, and we are here and we won. It's very exciting. It's what we wanted.
Coach, you utilize your left side a lot, a whole lot.
Mm-hmm.
Do that all year?
Well, we have two good middles. We have 2 very good outsides. You know, realistically, last year, Maggie Camp on the outside. Last year when we were here, she played right side for us. And she worked hard over the summer, played club last year, and just came back. And for all us coaches, opened our eyes at the way she was playing on the left side. So anytime you have someone that tall that can swing and put a ball down, setters tend to get comfortable with certain hitters. And at the end right there, when push came to shove and we had to close the game out, Maddie made some great choices in her sets and used her best hitter out there at the time. Maggie did a great job and put that ball away. So.
Coach, at times your servings had a share of struggles out there. How concerned were you that you're just giving them too many free points?
Well, anytime you try to serve aggressive, that's one thing that we told the girls coming into this game is, you know, we have to be aggressive on our serve. We heard what happened to them in yesterday's game, in that second game that they lost. So our focus was taking it to them right from the serve. And anytime you try to do that, you're going to miss some points. You're going to miss some serves and give them some easy points off of that. But we told the girls all season, if you're going to miss aggressive.
Girls, can you talk about just falling behind early, but then
I feel like that's happened to us a lot this season. We lose the first game and we come back and win the next two. But I mean, I guess the first game was just a wake up call. Yeah.
I like the way you came out in the second. I mean, you came out real strong.
Mm-hmm. They had the run in the first game, and then we definitely had the run in the second game in the first few points, which helped.
Once the second game was in you got that on there.
Yeah. Volleyball is a whole game of momentum, and in the first game it was just going back and forth, and they wound up with it at the end. And in the second game, it's a whole new game, and we knew that. And we just wanted to start off strong and take the momentum for the whole game, and I think that we did that. And to start off strong and to keep that going through the whole game really helped us, especially for the third game. Winning the second game has a lot of momentum for the third, and we did it.
Coach, for those of us down south that don't like change, everybody, all the camps are sisters, cousins.
They'd be the best people to explain it.
Me and Maggie are sisters.
Okay.
And then we are both first cousins with Emily Camp.
Okay.
And then all three of us are second cousins with Madison.
So are you go to the family reunion?
You know, I'm still trying to get invited to that one. So.
Third, fourth, and fifth
cousins. We have a lot. Yeah, it's very fun, especially for me and Maggie as sisters. We get to do everything together and go to practice together and win together and lose together, and it's been very fun. And with Emily and Maddie, and we're all very close, and as a whole team too, very close as a team, and it's a lot of fun to win together.
It's interesting to watch Maggie and Stacy, because you'd think they'd get sick of each other, living together, driving together, going to school, and then 2.5 hours after school of practice. But, I mean, they were roommates, and we said, well, what would happen if you were split up for roommates? And they said, well, that would stink because we packed together, you know? But, I mean, they get along very well, which is surprising because not many sisters do.
Any more questions?
Breese Central finishes the year 30-12 and is the runner-up in Class 2A. With us from Breese Central are Meredith Timmons, head coach Jim Cook, Jenna Heeman, and Maddie Timmerman. Coach, can you give us some thoughts on the game to start?
Well, it just started out fast and well in the first game. Went, you know, point for point and was able to win. And we just didn't get started again in the second game very well. And third game, again, was point for point, and we let a couple of things drop in the end that just happened. So, you know, our serving went a little bit weak, but played hard, second. Not what we wanted, but it's good. Didn't think we'd be anywhere near here, right, Chug?
Right, that's what I was saying. I really wanted to stay title, but from where this team was in late September and October, second place, the team broke, just going together.
Right. Huge, huge comeback. These girls worked hard.
Questions? Jenna, just talk about the fact that you guys couldn't stop their left side hitters. That was the hardest part.
I just felt like our blocks weren't as good as they normally have been. We just had some mistakes that we couldn't pick up, and we tried our hardest, but it just wasn't enough.
Manny, can you talk a little bit, as a freshman, you're playing JV ball, and you're ending your season, sitting up here in the second place. I mean, just talk about your season a little bit.
It felt, I don't know what to say. Good, I guess. I don't know, I didn't expect to make varsity, but I did. Yeah, that's about it.
Would you talk about just the fact that you couldn't stop their left side?
Well, I Yeah, I think what Jenna was saying, at times we got a little bit too much in a swing, you know, instead of getting right on the ball. Our whole concept on the block is to block and take away the cross court and try to force them to hit line. And because that's a much more dangerous shot, but, you know, a lot of kids can do it, but it's more dangerous because you're playing with the out-of-bounds line. But I think possibly we kept floating out a little too far, and so when you do that, you block split also. So now you not only have the possibility of getting through that hole, which, you know, the defenders have to play outside the block. When you're getting through a hole, create, because your blockers separate, then the defender has to try to read that and move in between them, and that's a, you put yourself in a difficult situation. Blockers got to block their spots and stay there so the defenders can read and know where to go. And I think we were just getting a little bit loose on that.
Did you talk about the block on their side as you tried to hit through that? I mean, their arms went up long and tall and tall as hers.
Yeah, it was very difficult for me. And I tried going line because that's what I normally do when I'm getting blocked, and they had line covered. So then after a while, I started hitting cross, and I got a few through, but they were blocking everything. And it was, so it was hard.
You guys had to swing there at the end. You guys were up a couple of points. Did they call timeout? What were you thinking?
I was thinking that we just needed to roll with it. We were ahead. We've been down in worse situations before. The Freeburg game, we were down 20-16, and we still came back on a 9-2 run. And I knew if we gave it everything we got, we could run with it, but we just made some mistakes that we couldn't pick up from.
Well, you know, yeah, it was something that I was concerned about. And people asked me about this game, and I said I was concerned because we're not that big of a team. I mean, we're not that tall. We got a couple people that are six foot, but we play mainly at, you know, mainly in the 5'10", but more so in the 5'8", 5'9", type. And just like Meredith said, it was really hard to find a hole. You know, we try to get the hitters maybe to hit off of their outside hands and make it, you know, fall off of those hands. But they were just so big at the net that they sealed off everything. And we don't play well when we play a tip game. And we play our best when we hit hard. So there wasn't a whole lot of adjustment that we could have done with that. I mean, we did get one. I think Meredith got a tip, or Paige, one of the two. One of the outsides got a tip over him toward the end of the game, but that wasn't going to work very long either, not with him.
Any more questions?